I was looking at my neighbor's garden one day, and it made me think, you know, gardening is a lot like life. If you want to have a beautiful flower garden, and theirs is much more beautiful than mine, you need to plan what you're going to plant, decide how you're going to arrange it, water it, fertilize it, and weed it. But sometimes, even in the best planned garden, a weed comes up. And in life, that's a lot like thistles. And in life, one of the thistles that comes up in life is anxiety. Now you have a choice. You can either pull out that thistle, you can ignore that thistle, or you can water it and nurture it and get a lot more thistles. One of the ways to do that is by the things you think about and by the beliefs that you have. I must be perfect is a great belief. It's a great self-talk to feed your anxiety and to make your anxiety stronger. Other beliefs that are good at feeding anxiety is always, never, I'm unlovable, I'm worthless. Sometimes anxiety develops into panic attacks. Now, if you've never had a panic attack, but you've ran just a little bit harder than you should, you know what a panic attack is like. It's when your heart is beating fast, you're sweating profusely, you maybe even start to get dizzy and feel like you're gonna pass out. But if you're running, just stop. If it's anxiety, you might not know where the seed of that panic attack came from or where the seed of that anxiety came from. It can come from a genetic predisposition. It can come from growing up in a family that feeds anxiety or breeds anxiety, like a family that has anxious parents or alcoholic parents. Or it might come from a traumatic event that you experience as an adult. But the thing about anxious people are, anxious people are often really creative people, really high achievers. They look like their life is great on the outside. And you don't know that that tiger of anxiety is chasing them, and they feel like they're on the run all the time. But there's clues to know if somebody is anxious. There's clues about what they say or what they do, what they don't do is even more diagnostic. One of the things that anxious people often don't do, they don't go to Walmart. I can't believe how many anxious people I see, and I say, do you shop at Walmart? And they're like, oh no, oh no. And there's a reason for that. Another thing that anxious people often say is, I have to have the TV on to go to sleep. You know, they need that noise. And another thing that's very common among anxious people, they have a lot of problems with sleep. And one of the problems with that is, when you listen to the TV and you go to sleep, you have poor quality sleep. So as you can imagine, that doesn't just affect the anxious person, it also affects their family. Anxious parents often create an environment that makes it more likely that their children will be anxious. Often anxious parents aren't able to do the things that they would like to do to support their children, or they do it with a great deal of stress. If you've ever looked at the seats in the high school, there's a whole section that kind of stays empty. It's the agoraphobic seats. Nobody with agoraphobia sits in the middle. So they're afraid to go there. It makes them very anxious to go to concerts. They might avoid going to sporting events or get there really early. So there's lots of things that you can do to have this beautiful bouquet of thistles in your life, if that's what you'd like. You want to be sure to not get enough sleep. Stay up too late, get up too early. There's certain shows and movies that you can watch to encourage this anxiety to grow into this beautiful bouquet. You want to watch movies that have themes of the world is not a safe place. And then there's things that you can do to cope with anxiety that will make it a lot worse. And that's you can drink a little too much, you can smoke marijuana. I mean, these are things that people really do. You can spend too much, you can gamble. All of these things are things that sometimes people with anxiety do to try to deal with it. But is that a rational solution or an irrational solution? Well, if you think about it, we all know that those are irrational choices. But the other thing about anxiety is lots of the beliefs that people have that feed anxiety are rational. So you want to listen to your self-talk. People with anxiety want to listen to their self-talk and think, is it rational or irrational? But then there's alternative choices that you can make that can make your life a calmer place. You want to exercise, spend time in nature, spend time with people that you enjoy, that you feel supported by, any kind of exercise, all of those are things that you can do that are going to make it better. You can also do things like get professional help to help treat anxiety, but there are great self-help books out there. This Don't Panic by Reed Wilson is a great choice for kids What to Do When You Worry Too Much is a great book to help with anxiety. Dr. Daniel Amen has written several books, including Change Your Brain, Change Your Life. So why should you get treatment? Why should you get help? Well, anxiety is one of those things that gets worse as you age, because the behaviors and the beliefs that anxious people often have support the anxiety and encourage the anxiety to grow. And then you crowd out the other beautiful flowers in your garden. So your goal is to identify and stop the behaviors that feed anxiety, stop the beliefs that support anxiety, and stop the self-talk that contributes to anxiety. And what happens when you do that? Well, like I said, anxious people are very creative, high-achieving people. But when that anxiety is cluttering up their mind and draining their energy and using their behavior, they're not able to be the productive, creative people that they're meant to be and that they would like to be. So when you clear that anxiety out, then you're able to free up that energy to be more productive. Oftentimes, anxious people wonder, am I crazy? No, anxiety isn't crazy. Anxiety is a disease like other diseases. And it's actually quite a common disease. About 15% of people have either a generalized anxiety disorder or a panic disorder at some time during their adult life. So you choose. You can choose the behaviors to have this beautiful bouquet of thistles, or you can have the beautiful bouquet of effective problem solving, healthy relationships, and a calm life. It's your choice. Thank you.